In the last class, we have seen variables and constants, right? There, that is called identifier. Means identifier are the thing. Just I will write. Identifiers are nothing but variables or constants. These two things we use in the program, right? If you type any C program, we use variables, we use constants. And see, we all have names, okay? We all have names. Likewise, whenever we are allocating anything in the memory, suppose 100, 102, this value, we need to give name to them. Like we have got the names, this memory location, this value should also get the names. Suppose I have named A, I have named B. On which basis I named A, on which basis I named B. So there are rules, okay? Now the first and most important rule is it should not have any keyword name. Means the first rule when naming any identifier is you should not use any of these words. Suppose you don't have any variable with name int. You never have any variable with name int. Okay, that is the first and important, okay, important rule. The second rule is you can use from A to Z, capital Z, okay, and numbers 0 to 9, okay. Then third rule, you can use underscore symbol. This is underscore. Apart from this, no other symbol is acceptable in your keyboard. You got several symbols, @, dollar, # dot, all symbols not used, only underscore we will use. And rule number four. What is the fourth rule is, we can use alphanumeric. Numeric. What do you mean by alphanumeric is, you can mix alphabets, you can mix numbers, okay, that is, you can use mix both of that and you can declare variable. Suppose a variable name can be A8. This is acceptable. A8 equal to 10. This is acceptable. Okay. Now we have seen what are the rules while form, like rules to be followed while naming any identifiers. First rule is you should not use any keywords. Keywords are here. Second rule is you can use in between A to Z, 0 to 9, combination also you can use. Only special symbol allowed is underscore, okay. Suppose you can have a variable name like underscore A equal to 15. This is acceptable. This is acceptable, okay. And you can use characters also for naming a variable. And there are some escape sequences were there. Just I tell you. I am erasing this, okay. There are some escape sequences. You don't escape, huh? Just see here. Escape sequences are nothing but these generally we use in output format. Whenever we are printing anything, we use these escape sequences. Just like /T. Use for horizontal tab, /V, vertical tab, okay, /B, back space, /N, new line. You may think like, sir has written all these things, I am not able to understand why. For understanding that, we need to erase another two things, okay, right? Okay. See, if you don't understand, just pause the video, okay? I will not go anywhere because this is already recorded. Go and have some water, then again come back here. We again meet, okay? Now just see here. Now what is meant by /T? Suppose in printf, you are writing hello, hi. In output screen, what it will print? It will print just hello, hi. Why? I already told you, printf will print the value in output. What it will print? Whatever in between double quotes, that only it will print. Now, what if we put slash t? Slash t means horizontal tab. Tab means 8 spaces. So, it will give 8 spaces and it will print hi. In the same line between hello and hi, it will give 8 spaces. What if I put slash v? Slash v. Then slash v means vertical tab. It will give 8 lines, okay, and it will print hi. Slash v means vertical tab. Now slash b. Slash b. Slash b means backspace. Just it will give one backspace. Means normal backspace, you know, right? Like backspace key, like above enter, you will find backspace. If you don't find, you just go to laptop or keyboard. You can see there. It will delete this one character and it will print hi. Okay, O is deleted. Now slash n. Slash n, new line. I think you have already guessed. I think you are very intelligent. Slash n means new line. So whenever I type slash n, hello will be there, and in the new line, hi will be printed. That's it. Most, actually there are other escape sequences also there, like slash R for carriage return, okay. Then slash O for octal, slash slash for printing, one slash, slash double quotes, okay, slash single quotes. Likewise, there are several escape sequences are there, but mostly we use these things only. Mostly we use, like in this also we use slash and slash t mostly, okay, slash n and slash t for tab and for new line, okay. While doing the programming, these are our best friends, okay. So new line, printf, we make friends, like we make lot of new friends, okay, that all 32 keywords also we will make our friends. Actually I forgot to tell one of the important rule. Rule number 5 is the maximum name length should be less than or equal to 31. Okay, the maximum allowed identifier name length should be less than or equal to 31. Okay, only that much size it can give to the variable or constant, or that is identifier. Okay, now to recollect everything, okay, just 30 seconds. 30 seconds rewind. Okay, now we have seen there are 32 keywords which are reserved by the compiler. Okay. What are the keywords? We are going to see daily. Second important point is there are some 5 rules for naming identifiers. What is identifier? Variables and constants are called identifiers. Now what are the 5 rules? First rule is the name should not be taken from keyword. We should not take it from the keyword. Second is we can use A to Z, 0 to 9. Okay. Third is we can use only underscore as a special symbol. Fourth is alphanumerics can be allowed. Fifth is the maximum length less than 31. And we have seen some escape sequences. Escape sequences are the things which are used for us to print. Like it will be useful for in output, like printing format. Some of the escape sequences are slash t, slash v, slash b and slash n. What are that? You can see here. Remaining things we will continue in next class. Until then, have a good sleep at night. Okay. Because research says how much ever we sleep well means there are some 4 levels of sleeping, like first level, second level, third level, fourth level. The fourth level is called some deep sleep. There is name for that and I forgot. That portion we should increase such that brain functionality will become very, very effective. Okay. My suggestion is just after this, go and sleep well, then come back. I will come with a new video, okay?